subsection 2 in this type of matter also takes care of all legal implications, like some money has been paid, some possession has been delivered. So restoring it back, restoration of possession back to the owner, refund the one party may have taken some advance earnest money, so restoration of the money, adjustment of some interest. So all these type of the necessities which the case may require may be taken care of by the court, and court will also grant these reliefs. Third one is, if the purchaser or lessee pays the purchase money or other sum which he is ordered to pay under the decree within the period referred, the court may, on application made in the same suit, award the purchaser or lease such further relief as he may be entitled, including in appropriate case execution of proper conveyance lease. Suppose A was demanding money from B to execute a sale deed. B paid the money, but A is still not executing. So A, so what court can do? Court can direct execution of the conveyance deed on behalf of A. Okay, Mr. A, you have taken money, you are not executing the sale deed in favor of B. The court will execute the sale deed on behalf of you in favor of B. So, conveyance deed maybe. So, it is a complete code regarding the any specific performance of agreement to sale, and if such contract has been rescinded. Number 4, no separate suit in respect of any relief which may be claimed under this section shall lie. This is a barring provision, because when law has given you the right here, so you claim all those, whatever you want to claim in this suit. If you are not claiming here, then you will not be entitled to file a fresh suit. So fresh suit for any relief which could have been taken under section 28, if not taken, will be barred. Separate suit will be barred. Subsection 5 is, the court may, proceeding under this section, shall lie in discretion of the court as usual. Cost is the discretion of the court. Kisko kitni cost dilani hai, kya dilani hai, balance of hardship. Number 29, alternative prayer for rescission in suit for a specific performance. A plaintiff instituted a suit for a specific performance of a contract in writing may pray in the alternative that contract cannot be specifically enforced, it may be rescinded and delivered up and be cancelled, and the court, if refuses to enforce the contract, this gives an alternative remedy. The party may, party who is seeking relief from the court for a specific performance, and party may in doubt, it may or may not be decreed, or party may be half-hearted, or party may be thinking of that if this specific performance is not possible or is not being done or will not be done, then in case the contract be rescinded and I may get my refund, whatever I have paid. So it is a legitimate thinking or legitimate claim of such party. So this provision, but these claims are to on different, you can say, the two claims are from two different directions. One claim is for a specific performance, you want to go east, and other claim is to rescind the contract and get it refunded back the earnest money, it is you are going to the west. So how the different and conflicting pleas can be taken? This is normally not possible in open litigation matters under suits filed under section 9. You have to take one stand. What do you want? Where do you want to go? But here this law specifically empowers you. What empowers? Empowers you ki you may seek specific performance, or in alternate you may seek the contract be rescinded. Here defendant cannot take the plea. This has already said, plaintiff has already pleaded in his pleading for rescission of the contract. So specific performance cannot be granted. So mere pleading by the plaintiff that he wants rescission of the contract will not be helpful for the defendant, because he is using the rights given by section 29, sorry, because 29 gives the power to claim for rescission of the contract in alternate. So in a suit for rescission of the contract in alternate, the party can also claim for rescission of the contract. Now 30, last section regarding contract. Court may require parties rescinding to do equity. Very natural principle, or as I told, before this contract, before this specifically effect, such type of the reliefs were granted by the Indian court for the centuries. The law of equity developed in Britain and that was followed in India or by Indian legal system. The same principle has been incorporated in section 30. On adjudging the rescission of a contract, the court may require the party to whom such relief is granted to restore any benefit which he may have received from the other party and make any compensation to him which justice may require. So if anything has been received, benefit has been received, it should be restored back. The justice demands, equity demands. And if any inconvenience and hardship has been faced, some pecuniary loss has been faced, it should be compensated. So on the basis of equity, so this is the provision where equity has been directly admitted as a tool for doing justice. Otherwise, law of equity is not in any statute. The law of equity developed in Britain by English courts, they used to do justice on the basis of such equities. What the justice demand? He has given money, the contract is rescinded, then he should restore back it. If somebody has suffered some loss on account of such contract, then some compensation should be given. So these are the equitable reliefs. And under section 30, in स्पेसिफिक टर्मिनोलॉजी, स्पेसिफिक टर्म्स, इक्विटी हैज बीन यूज्ड. सो इफ एनीबडी टॉक्स टू यू रिगार्डिंग इक्विटी एंड आस्क यू हाउ लॉ ऑफ इक्विटी इज इनकॉर्पोरेटेड इन इंडियन लीगल सिस्टम or in Indian legal statutes, but so you must mention this provision section 30 where the term equity itself has been incorporated in an institute. Otherwise you will hardly find the term equity in any statute. The remedies may be, the basis of the remedies may be equity, but equity as such has not been made part of statutory law in India. So this is a unique provision where equity has been made a part of statutory law. Equity has been recognized by the statute to do justice. I have not come across with any other section where equity was incorporated. So this is the another part is completed, or the contract part is completed, where rescission of the contract, specific performance of the contract, both in alternate can be claimed, and all about how this litigation of the parties at variance or in dispute under a contract can get resolved their issues with the help of court of law, and how the court of law will decide the issues in a very speedy manner and with a very specific and quick remedy to the person in need. Another type of the specific remedy is rectification of the instruments. Instruments, section 26, instruments means deed, some gift deed, it is an instrument, sale deed, adoption deed, lease deed, any document executed is an instrument. So what is the need for rectification of the instrument? Because instruments have been executed bilaterally, both the parties have executed a document, but on account of some fraud or maybe not under fraud, some mistake, some inadvertent mistake, some mistakes have been committed, and one party brings such mistake to the notice of the other party, but other party ignores it, refuses it to get it rectified. When a document is executed by both parties, both parties can rectify by a subsequent deed. But now the difference has come, because by that mistake, one party may be undertaking some benefit, may be beneficial to some party, and the same mistake may be detrimental to the other party. So such party would like to get it rectified, and other party would not like to get it rectified. So dispute arose. dispute arises, then such party who wants rectification of the document may file a suit, and the court after hearing the parties and their evidence, pleading, what is the ground for rectification, whether it is a bona fide mistake or not a bona fide mistake, whether it was a result of the fraud, considering all the aspects, if court comes to the conclusion that such mistake should not be mistake should be corrected, then court may pass a decree to the effect regarding the correction of this instrument. So this specific relief act also take care of such cases arising out of the mistakes, where mistakes may be result of fraud, mistake may be result of inadvertence, mistake may be result of typing error or anything else, and parties are not agreed to correct it. So one party may file a suit to get it corrected through court of law, and court has been given power to rectify the contract. So this is section 26 regarding rectification.